Hi, my name is Diana Umpierre. I'm a certified planner, a geographer, an environmental scientist, a resident of South Florida, and a volunteer board member with the International Dark Sky Association that for over 25 years have been addressing the need to protect the night environment. IDA accomplishes this by working closely with officials like you, planners, architects, and others to ensure that public policies incorporate environmentally responsible lighting best practices. I'm here to implore you to repeal the Meteor Tower, which is a damaging zoning policy, because it affects people, it encourages energy waste, and it endangers wildlife, like the many species that use this corridor by air and sea. If today you choose to ignore this, then I implore you to at least fix your zoning, to provide protections that are truly measurable, enforceable, consistent with better practices. Your zoning provides no protection. It allows cumulative environmental effects to compound by only limiting light trespass relative to ambient levels. That basically means that as your ambient light goes up, you're allowing then increased brightness of these LED displays. More light pollution, more light pollution. Also, your candle foot, you know, your foot candle allowances are much brighter than it is in other ordinances across the U.S. To address this, I recommend that you define different allowable brightness levels for day and night. For instance, in Pittsburgh, the day max is 2,500 nits, and at night it is 10 times less. Define curfews, such as times of the night to turn off the displays and during bird, sea, migratory seasons, to reduce sky glow and wildlife attraction to urban landscape, such as birds. May I allow one more minute? Thank you.
Somebody yell 2 minutes to you.
Okay, may I continue? Thank you, sir. Okay.
Yell 2 minutes for you.
Thank you. Okay. Define curfews. Again, I explained curfews, which are really important, and it is best practice. Even New York City, the city that supposedly never sleeps, is already implementing curfews. Increase the dwell time when images do not change. 6 seconds is fast too dangerously distracting to most people. And in Pittsburgh, again, the dwell time is 30 seconds. That's the time when images don't change. I also recommend that you create an outdoor lighting advisory board to examine what else in your code can be made better. I honestly believe that the people and the visitors to Miami, they don't want brightly lit illuminated commercials over the Miami skyline. But if you choose to ignore these, and then I recommend spend time fixing the code. I'm leaving you examples, you know, in the handout of better ordinances that are way better than yours. They mitigate environmental impacts and reduce light trespass, glare, and sky glow. So what I'm recommending for you today is to do what's right, not just what's legal. I'm not voting against the other elements of the zoning, you know, the innovation district. There are a lot of wonderful things as a planner. I think they're great. It is only the tower that I'm recommending that you oppose. Please vote no to PC 16 and vote yes to PC 17. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay.